Welcome to this week's edition of the First Reading, where I'll go over the first reading of the Daily Mass for the week, because the Daily Mass always focuses on a certain section of salvation history in the first reading. So this week's salvation history focus is on the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians, just like we've been doing for the past 2 weeks at Daily Mass as well. So on Monday, Paul starts going into specific problems that the Corinthian community has. The first one on Monday, he goes over that a man in the community is living with his stepmother and he's proud of his actions. So then Paul is saying, well, you gotta let him go. You have to make sure that he understands the error of his ways by getting him out of the community until he repents. Or as Paul says, the destruction of his flesh will lead to the salvation of his soul. So that's on Monday, Paul reproaching the community member because of his pride for his sin with the stepmother. On Tuesday, we take a break from Corinthians, and actually, since it's the birthday of the Blessed Virgin Mary, or we celebrate the birthday of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the first reading is actually from the prophet Micah. A few hundred years before Jesus was born, Micah predicted that the Savior would come from the town of Bethlehem. And so that's the book that we read from in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We're celebrating her birthday on September 8th. On Wednesday, we have Paul giving his opinion to people that are both married and not married, especially when it comes to the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So Paul says that in his opinion, since he thought that the Lord Jesus was coming in all of their lifetimes, he says, whatever state of life you're in right now, stay in that state. So if you're single right now, don't go looking for a husband or a wife, since the Lord is coming soon. If you're currently married, just stay married. Don't change your state of life because the Lord is coming soon. The most important thing for everyone to realize is that the world in its current form is passing away. So that's Paul's advice to the Corinthian community for Wednesday. On Thursday, Paul tells people to take care of the new members' conscience. So specifically, Paul was talking about meat sacrificed to idols. So even though Paul recognizes that there's no sin in eating meat sacrificed to idols because these idols don't exist, there's nothing that happened to the meat during the sacrifice of the meat to the idols. But Paul says if you eat that, then you might be scandalizing the new members of the community. Since their consciences aren't as fully formed as the other members, they might go away from God by seeing other community members eat this meat sacrificed to idols. So then Paul advises that even though it's not a sin to eat this kind of meat, you shouldn't, just for the sake of the new members of the community so that they're not scandalized. On Friday, Paul compares his ministry to that of an athlete's. So just like an athlete pushes his body to the very limit to win what he calls a perishable crown, so the same way Paul has done the same thing. He has received this order from the Lord Jesus Christ to go out and preach, and he pushes himself to the very limit the same way an athlete does. But in his case, the crown is to preach the gospel to all nations. And then finally on Saturday, Paul recognizes that whatever we celebrate or whatever we worship, we're participating in the life of the person that we're worshiping. So first Paul goes over demons, and he says that if people sacrifice to demons, they are participating in the life of demons. But then on the other hand, whenever we participate in the bread and the cup of our Lord Jesus Christ, whenever we participate in that, we are participating in his life, specifically in we are participating in his death and his resurrection every time we partake in the breaking of the bread and the sharing of the cup. And so that's the preview of the week for the first Mass, or for the first reading at Daily Mass. I hope this helps understand better this section of salvation history so that when we do follow them in the first reading of Daily Mass, we'll be able to understand them better. Thanks for watching. Until next time.